Alright guys, here we are. Time to just show you guys where I lived. I lived in Musashi Shinjo. You guys might remember this place right here. I blurred it out a bit, but maybe some of you guys can tell from when I kicked out Kelly from my place. This is the park where we was chilling and shit, and it was snowing all the time. And then there, if you guys remember, that's one time when we saw the man that was beating somebody or whatever. You guys really have to watch the old channel to get most of this. Here's the place right here. I was in 403 right here. Got my little NHK thing. I never paid for it, but it was cool. They always ask you for the money and shit. A lot of memories of this place, man. Been here for about 2 years. You guys kind of, if you've been with the channel for a while, you might have remembered everything that when I first checked out this place, and it was between this place, a 2DK apartment. This is a 2DK apartment and a 3DK. Oh shit. Shit. Oh, I gotta take this home today. Oh, damn it. It's not even a good vacuum too. Shit. Okay. Oh well. Anyways, this is all the stuff I gotta carry home, and I gotta take out this desk. So, like as I was saying, let me take my mask off. This is a 3LDK. I mean, this is a 2DK, and that basically means, for those of you that aren't familiar with the system, 2DK is two rooms in a dining area. Two rooms in a dining area. I'm in a, moving to a 3LDK, which is three rooms, living room, and a dining, dining and kitchen, DK. Dining, which this is supposed to be dining area, and this one, like kitchen as well, which is hard to believe, I know. This kitchen was actually not too bad, a little low for me. I didn't like it so much, but for my girl, it was fine. But for me, it was way too low to be cooking all the time. So, and the room was not, it wasn't a lot of space at all when doing some shit. We cleaned up everything fairly well, if I do say so myself. Making sure, get some of that money. There's some shit right there, but honestly, unlike America, it's not even worth it, with this place anyways, to clean the place really well, like spick and span, because, They basically were stating you're not going to get any of your money back. I'm like, why the fuck am I doing this then? Other places I've gotten money back, which is crazy, but I'm like, fine. So we cleaned it a little bit, but I mean, fairly a lot compared to what was there before. She did a really good job, actually. But yeah, dirty ass shower. Anyways, let's move over to the stuff you guys are probably more interested in over here. So this is my bed, where my bedroom was. Where fuck. fuck around, I mean. And I would watch Dragon Ball. Actually, my girl would watch Dragon Ball Super right here. It's kind of funny, like I know none of you guys can really piece any of this together. This is where Callie was on my bed many times. But anyways, we had a nice view. Like that one time she was propped up on all fours. You guys remember that video, right? And she was looking out here to see the view. She got a nice view. Anyways. And that's that right there. It was cool. Sometimes some of you might remember this from when it was snowing and shit. Alright, moving over here. Small closet space though. This is, believe it or not, this is basically for one person. This place living here was for one person or maybe two small Japanese people. And this is the main thing I wanted to show you guys. This is the room. This is where it all happened. The Red Dreaded Studios was right here. And I left the posters up there just for now so you guys can have an idea of how small of an area I was really working with. This is essentially, it's the same space over here. This is called, these things down here are called tatamis, okay? Tatamis. And the way rooms are measured in Japan is by how many tatamis you can fit in one place. So this one over here is 6 tatami, and this is also 6 tatami. So we say tatami jo, or sorry, rokujo, rokujo, six tatami. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you see? And I did my best to cover it with carpet so it doesn't get torn up and all that. But as you can see, even with the carpet, I don't know, there's discoloration. I don't know if it's mold or whatever, but there's some discoloration. If you guys remember, my computer was right here. This is my computer. So if you look from this angle, camera on, pull it up, boom, right there. That's right about here is where I was shooting when I was by my, cause I had no fucking space. The TV was right here, right? And so this is where everything happened. Everything went down right here. And that's why I always had this weird damn blurry angle every time I would shoot something from this angle. My iPhone's pretty damn good, but it was so close to the wall, that's the most I could back it up with. And I tried so many different angles to work with. Right over here, if you look, you can kind of tell that's essentially where the couch was. And originally, if you kind of remember when I first moved in, the couch was right here, and we had the backdrop and all that going on, and I had this ugly desk. This is the desk I was using for a while over here, but I just had no room to put the TV in and to put my actual computer table and streaming and all that other stuff. So now we are expanding, baby. We are making this bigger. Callie's got her own section in the closet for all her outfits. Probably put some mannequins around so we can maybe put one of DC's costumes in the back, DC Sun's costumes in the background. We got a lot of good stuff to show you guys, and I just wanted to share this with you about how it all looks, how it all went down. This is basically all the closet space I had. And for in the beginning it was fine, till my girl wanted to move in. And it that made things fairly damn stressful in terms of space. Because over here, I had a semi-double, I still have that semi-double bed. And that took up most of the rokujo, six tatami, right? I had no space after that. It was very hard. Now, traditionally living, traditional Japanese style living, your bed should actually go right here, okay? So your bed should actually, and not even a bed, it's actually a futon. This is actually pretty damn soft. It's actually pretty damn comfortable if I wanna lay down and take a nap or some shit. Oh! Most people, well, old school Japanese people, they actually sleep on this. They put a mattress right here and then they lay down on it. It's not bad. I couldn't do it every day. I feel like I could do it right now and maybe it'd be okay. But on a day-to-day basis, I've tried doing this, sleeping on a futon, on a tatami and then on a futon. It's not comfortable. When you start getting used to it, it makes it really difficult to sleep. I'm fairly tired today, so I could probably just pass out right now on this and I'm fine. But that's basically how you do it. You get this rolled up futon, you lay it out every day, and that's the big problem. You need to lay it out every day. And the idea is the fact that this whole area should be fairly clean and like little to nothing, minimalist thinking of furniture here, so that when you're done, you roll this bad boy up and you put it in that closet area and go about your day. That doesn't really work well for a YouTuber and all around entertainer. So that's why I put the bed over there, because I needed a proper place for the studio. Originally I was thinking about putting a studio over there, but the problem was is that window was kind of a necessity for, you know, some nice air or something like that, and it was going to be too hard to film every day in that particular room. So that's why I changed it up and I put the bedroom over there and I put the tatami over here. But it was a little weird sometimes, and I don't really like tatami smell for too long. Like, it's this like really woodcut smell, that like grass smell, that I'm not a big fan of. So yeah, if you come live in Japan, be careful about that, because there's a lot of older apartments that have this tatami smell. Honestly, yo, if I had an extra room to do nothing in, I would kind of like to have one tatami room because it does have this cool Japanese feel to it, but it's just so ineffective. Like, I swear, like, I was so mad this day. That's not a period stain. That's not a shit stain. I was so mad that day when I first moved in, or when my girl came over and she spilled something and we couldn't get the, I think this was wine or something. We couldn't get that shit out. I was so mad about that. These might be jizz dropping. Honestly, I don't know why this one is discolored so bad, either from the light or my chair. I don't know. I think it was just exposed to the light longer because my chair would wheel around in that one. So anyway, something to keep in mind. This little lever thing is, I don't even know. I have no idea what the hell this is supposed to be for. You're just supposed to butt fuck it or something. I don't know. I think it was like, there you go. I think somebody said it was like to do laundry or some bullshit. I don't know, man. Sex games. Anyways, guys, that's it. That's all I wanted to show you guys. I want to show you where I was living. Now that I moved out, I can give you the house tour. So no, none of you crazy ass stalkers will follow me. Is it raining? Nah, it's not raining. And I used to just come out of here quite often when things would get a little too stressful or whatever. I just come out of here, think. I always like a nice view. My new place has a pretty damn good view, if I do say so myself, so that'll be good for me to look at. But a view is very important, I feel, for you guys. For people, you know, to stay creative, keep going. I would come out here 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning sometimes, just watch the sun come up, and I think that's important for inspiration, okay? So guys, stay inspired. I hope you enjoyed the tour of my place. 2DK. Next time, I'll show you the 3LDK, okay? Take care, y'all. I'm out. Peace. Fade to black.